Have you ever wondered why in C# we sometimes use iQueryable, other times iEnumerable, and sometimes list? These are actually so confusing. Here's a true story. When I first started, I built a web app. Everything looked fine, until a few queries took forever to run. Or worse, a query crashed because I tried to add something into an iEnumerable. It literally gave me a heart attack. Not recommended for developers. Back then, I thought these three didn't have a huge difference. But the truth is, choosing the wrong one can literally kill your app's performance. So, to prevent any more developer heart attacks, let's dive deep into them. All right, let's break this down. We've got three players: iQueryable, iEnumerable, and List. Now, first up, iQueryable. This is actually quite easy to understand. Just look at the name, query. It means we're not grabbing the data yet. We're just building a query plan. Think of it like writing down your order at a restaurant. One salad, no onions, extra cheese. You're not eating yet, you're just describing what you want. That's what we call deferred execution. I guess you might have already heard about the term deferred execution before, but what it actually means? It just means the action is delayed. In this example, this query hasn't hit the database at all. It's just sitting there, like your order note in the waiter's hand. You can keep adding more instructions, like skip, take, select. And all the details are just instructions waiting to be executed. So when is the time it gets executed? The magic happens only when you finally say, okay, give it to me. That's when you call things like to list, count, or first or default. At that exact moment, the whole query is translated into SQL and executed directly on the database. Why is this so powerful? Because all the heavy lifting, like filtering, sorting, paging, happens in SQL, right where the data lives. That means your web server isn't sweating bullets trying to filter millions of rows. The database does the hard work, and your app just gets the final, nicely packaged results. Now, let's move on to iEnumerable. Here's where things get a little tricky. With iQueryable, we were just preparing the recipe. But when we call asEnumerable, we're switching gears. Everything before asEnumerable is still iQueryable, running in SQL. But everything after that? Now we're working in memory, with link to objects. At this point, the SQL database already did the initial filtering. But once we hit asEnumerable, anything else we do after that will happen in memory, row by row in C#. So why would we ever do that? One big reason: not everything can be translated into SQL. For example, say we want to use a custom C# function. If we try this on iQueryable, error. The database doesn't know about your custom C# function, so you'll get this error. That's why we sometimes pull the rows into memory first with iEnumerable, then apply that custom logic row by row in C#. But here's the catch. If you're dealing with 10 rows, it's no problem. If it's 100,000 rows, your server might cry and burn out. Running everything in memory can blow up the memory usage or cause timeout. So it's better to keep it as iQueryable for as long as possible and only switch to iEnumerable when you really need in-memory logic, like regex or complex conditions. Now you might be thinking, if iEnumerable already gives me data in memory, why do I still need list? Great question. iEnumerable is like a read-only stream. You can loop through it, but you can add or remove items. That's where list comes in. A list is flexible. You can add, remove. It's a dynamic collection. That's why in real-world apps, you'll see lists everywhere. They're simply more practical and flexible than arrays or iEnumerable when you need to work with the data after fetching it. And finally, we can return the list of data to the view. Now here's an important note. We can't just return an iQueryable straight to the view. We must materialize the query before returning it. We can't serve our customer the recipe or the raw ingredients. We have to cook it and put it on a plate. That's exactly what calling to list does. It finalizes the query and brings the data into memory so we can finally return it to the view. But here's the part to be careful about. Materialize at the very last step. For example, if you pull the entire table into memory and then filter, that will kill performance. So always keep it as iQueryable for as long as you can and only call to list at the end. Okay, now you might ask, we can also materialize into an array, right? Yes, you can also materialize into an array with toArray. But arrays are fixed size. You can't just add or remove items directly like this. Technically, you can resize an array and add new item like this. But under the hood, that's just creating a new array. That's why lists are the go-to in modern apps. They're flexible, efficient, and easy to work with. So, here's the big picture. iQueryable is like the query instructions. We can keep building those instructions as much as we want, and they only get executed in the database when we call something like to list, first or default, or count. IEnumerable is like the ingredients on the table. It's data and memory, kind of like a read-only stream. We can loop through it, but we can't add or remove items. List is the final plate of food that's ready to serve. It's a dynamic collection that's editable and can handle further operations. Pick the right one, and your code runs smoother, your server stays cool, and you save yourself from yet another developer heart attack. Okay, I hope this video helps you. Thanks for watching.